So the Anthem Film Festival has been part of FreedomFest for 10 years. This is your 10th anniversary. Tell us a little bit about FreedomFest for people that don't know about it and why we're in Rapid City, South Dakota, because we're normally in Vegas, right?
That's right. So I started the film festival in 2011, partly because I wanted something separate to do. Tammy Holland was running Freedom Fest at the time, and she was a very hands-on person. And the other thing was, I felt like we were doing a great job with politics and history and economics and finance and science and technology. We had an arts and literature track, but we weren't really doing a lot with it. I would give a speech about an author every year, and we would bring in a few people to talk about art and sports, and we even had one on bird watching one time. But I wanted, so part of it was to have a stronger arts component at Freedom Fest. But the other was, I love film. My son's a filmmaker. I actually took them out of school for a dentist appointment the day that Batman opened so they could all go to the movies with me. So we're a movie-going mother and children.
That's
Mark
a
is a
righteous reason to skip out.
Oh, absolutely. Anytime we had something, but my kids never got the 100% attendance award because there was always something better to do. And movies were one of them. So I love movies, but I was saddened to see how filmmakers who love liberty had to kind of hide that. And if they did a liberty-oriented film, they often used their initials rather than their name and wanted to keep it secret. And I thought, if I created a venue, then they could have the content. And it's worked really well. We have Freedom Fest with over 2,000 people, this year 2,600 people. So that provided my audience, and my filmmakers provided the content, and I just put everything together. And over the years, it has grown in content. The quality of the content has improved, the quantity of the films that I get. So I'm just really, really pleased with what we've done in 10 years.
It's kind of funny. You were ahead of the curve because I remember some of the movies that conservatives and libertarians were trying to make a decade ago, and they were so self-aware that it was like being bludgeoned over the head with like a Mises quote or something. And we just weren't very good at it. But today Anthem is kind of that cutting edge of there's a lot of great storytellers that show up.
So it's our 10th anniversary, and we're bringing back some of our best films from previous years. And one of them is called Everything. RJ Daniel Hanna is the director. That was the first film I ever saw of his. And since then, I've had four or five of his films that he's such a humble director. He doesn't splash his name all over, and usually it's the organization that gets the credit. He's a phenomenal director. But the story, it was done by Institute for Justice. They took it to the Supreme Court, and it's the story of a mother whose daughter is dying from leukemia, and she needs a bone transplant. And they have found a donor, and it's a match, but the problem is the donor can't afford the time off from work, and it takes 5 to 6 weeks to recover when you donate bone marrow. It's like blood, it regenerates. So it's not like selling a kidney, it regenerates. But the mother whose daughter is dying is desperate to get this donation, and the single mother who is the match wants to do it, but financially she can't afford to do it. She'll lose her job. The mother whose daughter is dying says, "I have $5,000. I'll give this to you. It'll cover all your expenses." But the problem is both of them could go to prison with that exchange. I could tell you that story, and intellectually you'd get it. But when you see this story on screen with these phenomenal actresses and the passion that they feel and the trauma that they feel that they can't do this thing together, this good thing that's not going to harm anyone, you really feel it. And that's the power of storytelling.